Weekdays at 5:30 on TV 12.
Funnier than busting loose. Funnier than the Happy Days came. We found the formula and you're going to love it. It's those funny guys. There's Dummy.
What do you mean a flank?
There's Jokey.
But girls, I was just kidding.
There's Fatty.
I ate it.
There's Pipsqueak.
Well, put me down.
And there's Brainy.
I think I've got a plan.
There's 5 laughs a minute, over 100 laughs a week. And we ought to know because we put them there. It's those funny guys.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. FCTV is now on the air. Starring John Candy. Joe Flaherty. Eugene Levy. Andrea Martin. Catherine O'Hara. Dave Thomas. And featuring Harold Ramis. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the FCTV Television Network.
The automobile just isn't designed.
I'm Phyllis Gumbel.
And I'm Keith Hampshire.
And this is SCTV Sports Central. Okay, let's not waste any time. There's probably nothing more exciting in sports. Nothing fires the imagination like a heavyweight championship fight. And boy, have we got a great one for you tonight. It's Gregorio Lopez, the current champ, unbeaten in 40 fights. Tonight looking stronger and better than ever. And his opponent, Hefty Neal. Well, Keith, what can you tell us about Neal?
Well, Phyllis, I think you have to go back to 1935. Let me set the scene for you. A muggy night in the polo grounds, a tremendous crowd screaming for blood. The heavyweight champ, Billy Dieselhead Collins, thought to be invincible, a hard man to hurt in the ring, going against a virtual unknown, total newcomer, Norman Rockwell. And what a battle it was. Dieselhead, of course, emerging eventually as the victor. It was a fight that ended Rockwell's boxing career. But, like a lot of boxers before him, he went on to become one of the great painters of his generation, joining the illustrious ranks of other boxer painters like welterweight Andrew Wyeth, featherweight Aubrey Beardsley, and then a heavyweight on any canvas, big man George Brock, who besides being a boxer
Keith,
and a painter...
Keith, this is all very interesting, but what's your point?
The point, Phyllis, is simply this. Neal must strike quickly tonight if he's going to take Lopez, because Lopez's combinations will take a devastating toll in the later rounds.
Yeah, those combinations can be deadly, huh, Keith? SCTV Sports has prepared a film on this challenger, Neal. Let's take a look at it.
How you doing? You see the fight? And what'd you think?
Well, I really didn't. Huh? When I said it.
What?
Well, then I couldn't say, and then I went too.
I can't understand you, girl.
Well, I really...
Huh? I really clobbered him, didn't I?
When you try to do that, I don't respond.
I can't understand what you're saying.
Well, I didn't know it, and I couldn't say
it. What the hell are you saying?
Hey, kid, I was watching your fight out there, you know?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I like your style.
Hey.
You know what I think you need? I think you need a manager, you know?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, look, I used to be a pretty good fighter myself, you know?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, maybe you heard of me. My name is Rocky Balboa.
Balboa.
Italian Stallion. They made a movie about me, huh?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Let me show you. Pretty good movie, too. Take a look at that, huh?
Hey, you got good style there, huh?
Yeah, good scenes in that.
Yeah.
Hey, now look, I used to be a fighter just like you, you know?
Yeah?
Yeah, I was a bum, too.
Hey, I'm not no bum.
Hey, you're a bum.
I'm not a bum.
You're a bum.
Hey, look, I said I'm not a bum. You want to know why? Because I'm fighting the heavyweight championship of the world in 3 days. That's why I'm not a bum.
Heavyweight championship, huh?
That's right. Why don't you just get out of here, huh? Sure. Come on, come on, get out. I don't need no manager. Where were you when I needed you, huh? Go on, get out of here. Call me a bum. You're the bum. Get out of here. I don't need anyone, you understand? I don't need anyone. Take your nerve coming in here calling me a bum. Manager. What do you think? You think I need a manager, huh?
Well, then I said I do.
Yeah, you got a good point. Yeah, he wasn't such a bad guy, was he?
Oh, I don't say it.
Yeah, I know. Hey, Rocky!
Hey, kid, hey. I knew you'd see things my way. Ah, oh, there's a contract.
Hey, I'm real sorry, you know?
Grown up. Hey, that's all right. Come on, we'll sign a contract.
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, you're gonna like me. I'll be a good manager.
I'll be a good fighter for you,
You're
gonna
be a good fighter. I'll just sign this thing first, huh? Hey, hey.
Okay, just sign it up there.
Just put the old John Hancock.
All right.
Hey.
Will you cut that out?
Okay, I'll put my name down, all right? Okay, you sign too.
All right.
We'll start training, all right? Hey, you gotta get in shape. That fight's in 3 days.
That's right.
We'll start training tomorrow, okay?
Hey, thanks again. I'm sorry about all this.
All right, one thing. Remember, before the fight...
Yeah?
No sex.
You got it, no sex.
Here.
Thanks again, huh?
Here.
Hey, come on. What are you doing? Where are you going?
Oh, my brother.
Hey, you can stick around here for a while, huh?
Yeah,
come on. Listen, don't you like it here?
Yeah.
You know, you're kind of cute, yeah?
Yeah.
You really are.
Well,
why don't you take your hat off?
No.
Yeah.
I got my brother.
You know, you're kind of cute without your glasses on. Huh? Hey, you know, say, what's that on your lip there?
We'll continue with SCTV's exciting film on this young challenger, Hefty Neal, right after these messages.
Hi. Hello. Boy, tuna is so expensive. It's a crime. Oh, look at the little skin. It's so soft and
pink.
Feel that, Kenny. That's enough. Easy, Kenny, easy. Okay, now you've read it.
Ken, what's going on here?
Chocolate for dust, can of tuna, and God knows what else.
Well, let's see what else. All right, what did you take?
I took a peach and I ate it, and that's all of us.
One peach? So why were there three peach pits behind the cut of fire? Talk! Come on, talk!
I got well.
Hello. I'm the manager.
Man.
How are you?
I'm fine.
What seems to be the trouble? You seem upset.
I took a can of tuna and a can of lobster and a package of frozen crab.
I thought so. What else?
I found a cherry and some floor polisher and some Dalmatian dog food.
Liver bits of chicken liver.
Liver bits! I took liver bits!
Shoplifting doesn't pay. It's easier to buy it. So don't take it unless you're sure you can get away with it. Okay, don't shoplift under any circumstances. If you want something, pay for it.
Ann has a lean, flat stomach.
07. Money back guarantee, so call now. 1-800-225-3030. That's 1-800-225-3030.
From Jamar, 50 of the world's greatest psalms recited by 50 of the world's greatest stars. 50 psalms you can play at parties, funerals, wakes, local disasters, political conventions, supermarket openings, or in the privacy of your own home. You'll hear Kirk Douglas reciting, "The Lord is my shepherd."
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Barbara Streisand reciting, "The heavens are telling."
The heavens are telling the glories of God.
Peter O'Toole reciting, "My heart overflows."
Oh, my heart overflows with a goodly theme.
Margaret Hamilton is the Wicked Witch of the West, reciting, "The Lord is my light."
The Lord is my light, my salvation. Who shall I fear?
John Duke Wayne reciting, "Give ear to my words."
Well, why don't you give ear to my words, O Lord? Give heed to my groaning.
50 of the world's greatest psalms recited by 50 of the world's greatest stars. A three-record set you'll want to share with your friends, family, neighbors, acquaintances, people you don't even like, people you don't even know. 50 of the world's greatest psalms recited by 50 of the world's greatest stars. $10.99 for records, $12.99 for tape or cassette from Jamar.
Hey, monkey. Hey, what are you doing? What are you eating? Come on, let's go out there. Come on, turn this thing off. Let's go out there. Give me breakfast. Let's go. Come on. Come on, let's go.
Let's get a snack.
Hey, you gained weight.
I always train that way.
Yeah, well, you're still a bum, you know that?
Come on.
That's right, you're always gonna be a bum.
Hello, Hefty.
Hey, come on, after the fight, huh? After the fight.
You sure have changed since I mentioned the pet shop. Your hair doesn't smell like kitty litter anymore.
Oh, Hefty, everything's going to be different from now on. You've got a chance at the heavyweight title. Well, I'm beautiful and articulate all of a sudden. I've got everything I want.
I just want one thing. I just want to be on my feet at the end of the fight. I don't care if I win. I just want to show them I can take it. 15 rounds, go the distance with a champ. Then I'm going to know that all the bums and losers in this lousy, stinking world really have a chance to make it.
Okay, kid, come on, let's go.
Oh, Hefty, don't forget your trunks.
Oh. Great piece of film.
Hefty hopes he can go the distance, and frankly, so do I. I borrowed a lot of money from the bank and placed a big fat bet on him.
Next Thursday night on SCTV.
Let's hope that bypass works. There's no signs of rejection, but we'll watch him closely for 48 hours.
Well, I think the bypass was an excellent choice, Ed. Bradshaw!
Yes, Doctor?
Take those dirty sheets down to the laundry room.
Right away, Doctor.
It's emergency orderly. Seven nights a week on the roughest medical unit there is gives Skip Bradshaw some experiences that ordinary men never see.
Skip!
Yes, Mrs. Pearson?
Oh, here.
Thanks. You're always here when I need you.
For people as nice as you, Mrs. Pearson, I make it my business to always be here.
Oh. I missed the bed.
I'll clean it up.
Roll over.
Emergency orderly. Next Thursday night at 8 o'clock. And following emergency orderly, a new kind of courtroom drama grips the screen. It's Court Clerk, the story of the man who keeps the record straight.
Your Honor, there seems to be some discrepancy in Mr. Arnold's testimony.
Would the court clerk please read back Mr. Arnold's previous testimony?
I left my apartment at 9:28, and when I hit the street, I saw four men standing behind a green sedan.
Aha! It was four men!
Perjury is a very serious offense and could get you a stiff jail term, Mr. Arnold.
It's a damn court clerk. Does he have to take down everything I say?
I'm afraid I do, Mr. Arnold. It's my job.
Court Clerk, following emergency orderly next Thursday night on SCTV.
Don Richards.
It's answered over 1.25 million calls since 1983.
We've cleared 3 hours of airtime just for this fight, so we're going to bring you blow-by-blow action.
And a terrific wrap-up after the fight. I see they're introducing the fighters. And now let's go to ringside with SCTV's Lou Jaffe.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the evening, 15 rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world. In this corner, the challenger from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 318 pounds. In the spotted trunks, the Croatian Dalmatian, Hefty Neer. And in this corner, the heavyweight champion of the world from Chihuahua, Mexico, weighing 210 pounds, Gregorio Lopez.
Lou Jaffe, and what an exciting boxing card we have lined up for you tonight. Gregorio Lopez defending his title against the young, aggressive Hefty Neer, a fighter, although relatively unknown, who could certainly go the distance. And this capacity crowd here tonight seems to know that. There is tension in the air as we wait for this much-publicized fight to begin. This reporter predicts it could be the fight of the century. And there's the bell to start round one. Corners determined. And Neer is down. It appeared to be a jolting uppercut. I couldn't quite see it. It was a phantom punch. An uppercut, I believe. It could have been a left hook. I'm not sure. 8, 9, 10. This fight is over. Gregorio Lopez knocking out Hefty Neer. This crowd is stunned. The fight is over. Phyllis, Keith, you saw it. Lopez is the winner.
Phyllis. What? Phyllis. Fight is over. Well, that's going to give us a couple more hours wrap up on the fight than we were planning. About 2.5 hours, to be exact. Phyllis, perhaps we should talk about it.
Well, Lou, I think it'd be interesting to see that lightning-fast punch in slow motion, possibly. How about it, Lou?
Phyllis, we do have a replay of that lightning-fast first round, and this is what it looked like not 2 minutes ago. There they are, both fighters leaving their corners, and Neil is down. That was the punch. I couldn't quite make it out. What can I say?
Lou, perhaps you could get a word with Lopez, the champion. I understand he has a really funny accent.
Lopez Keith is probably in his dressing room by now. He left the ring immediately after the punch was thrown.
Well, how about Hefty...
He's not here!
Well, how about Hefty Neil, Lou? Is he able to speak?
Hefty Phyllis is not here either. He was carried out to a waiting ambulance, and by the time I get down to the hospital, what with the Friday night traffic and so forth, I...
Lou, perhaps we could take another look at that replay.
Why?
I don't know. I'd just like to see it again.
Right you are, Keith. This is what it looked like, folks, not 3 minutes ago. There they are, the fighters in their corners, both looking quite determined and sweating already, and Neil is down. That was the punch. It looked like an uppercut, a left hook, possibly a very strong jab. I didn't see the...
Well, tell me, Lou, do you think it looked like a premeditated fight plan that Lopez seemed to be following? Did it seem to be one that caught Neil and all of us completely by surprise?
I honestly couldn't tell you, Phyllis.
Lou, let me ask you this. I know that all of us here at Sports Central, certainly the fans, were hoping that this fight would last a lot longer than it did.
3 hours.
What we want to know here at Sports Central is, how do the fans feel? Are they disappointed?
Keith, there is absolutely no one left in the arena. I seem to be the only person here. Some started to file out as soon as Neil hit the canvas. My capsule comment?
Well, Hefty Neil certainly must be a disappointed young man, Lou. How do you think tonight's fight will affect his future? Lou?
Lou?
Lou!
That was Lou Jaffe at ringside. Well, it looks like we have some time on our hands here, Phyllis, and what an opportunity to take this time now to talk about some other big things.
Well, that was some fight, wasn't it, Keith? Oh, that was exciting. Now, let's quickly take a look around the world of sports. Not too much going on there.
This has been the last in a series of live special presentations from SCTV. Next week, be sure to tune in for the premiere of Half-Wits, an all-new and exciting game show on SCTV. More than 100 years a watch.
Now here's an impressive collaboration. Labyrinth, a new fantasy adventure film produced by George Lucas, the creator of Star Wars, directed by Jim Henson, the inventor of the Muppets, and starring the multi-talented David Bowie as the cruel, evil something or other. Now I'm not too clear on the story of this one, but I think it's about a little girl who's lost in like a land of some kind, and she has to find some magic thing to break some kind of a spell, and some monsters try and get her, but some cute things help her, and everything works out in the end. Woo! Gives me chills just thinking about it.
So the labyrinth's a piece of cake, is it? Well, let's see how you deal with this little slice.
No, the cleaners!
What?
Run!
done for you.
Working with David was fabulous. He's really fun to work with, made me feel very comfortable. Always very fun atmosphere on the set, which was nice.
Apart from being quite beautiful, she's a really good actress. And she's a pleasure to work with. One forgets that she's just 14 years old and she's really very mature. And it's a big strain, a film like this. And every day without fail, she was on form. And she's absolutely terrific.
And she's a bright, intelligent actress who takes direction well. And everything was just right. And it wasn't until we were actually shooting that I realized that there were scenes that were both difficult and uncomfortable and not exactly dangerous, but slightly risky, or they would feel dangerous.
Jim would say, 3, 2, 1, drop! And they would just sort of, you know, throw me down, and all these hands grabbing at me as I'm going. It was an experience. It was definitely an experience.
Obviously underground, because just from the little trip that she makes through the tunnel of hands took me into the underground. So I set that as the sort of area for the song.
What do you mean, help? We are helping. We are helping hands.
The film ostensibly deals with the girl's emotions and what she's going through and discovering about herself and her parents and her relationship to her family.
What plastic is that?
Hoggle crew are five performers, one of which is really an actress, Sherry. He's a full-fledged actress. She's inside the costume. The other four members of the crew are all radio crew, myself included. Five performers trying to get one character out of one puppet is a very tough thing. It's always been the biggest problem with these type of characters, where you have radio controls everywhere. Basically, what it takes is a lot of rehearsing and getting to know each other, getting to know each other's timing, so that when I go here, you know, something like that, the eyes go here, you know, and Sherry goes here, and, you know, everybody does it at the same time.
It's an unbelievable amount of effort that goes into making just one, you know, one creature work.
Sarah.
Well, tomorrow, do join us because we're going to check out.
Hello, you've reached the car phone of Harold Ramis. I can't talk to you right now because I'm in the back seat. But if you watch this next segment, you'll find out all you need to know about the hip, hot, and happening soundtracks being released this summer. Leave your name and number at the end of this segment, and be sure to buy the Club Paradise soundtrack available on Columbia Records and Tapes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, we with Jimmy Cliff playing the owner of a resort, we naturally made his band the house band at the resort, and his music is so incredible to me, and in a way it inspired the whole cast all during the shooting. So spiritually it was real important, and it turns out great in the movie.
No one can blame you for walking away.
I wanted something very emotional, and for me, the most emotional music I can think of is gospel.
Little bit louder now, little bit louder now, little bit louder now, I'm living underground.
I think it's a lot about how life can treat people, and by just pure chance your whole life can change.
I always think of it as Purple Rain gone sports.
Rod Temperton called me. He and Dick Rudolph had written the songs, and that was the one that I seemed the best suited for.
I wanna give you my love.
Mike Chapman, who produced this track, played it for somebody that was something to do with the film, and they said, well, this is just what we want for Legal Eagles. So that's how it came about.
The rock and roll aspect of How Did That is really authentic. That's the main thing that we've gone for, is that the band are singing their own songs. It's not like Actresses with their voices being replaced by session singers.
When I agreed to direct the picture to Dino, I said, I want to make the loudest motion picture ever made, bar none, since talkies came in. And the only group that can allow me to do that, that can score this picture, is AC/DC.